have support. I knew there was something wrong. Then they also, our company also offered us support with like psychiatrists and stuff. So I called up those psychiatrists, and then in the end I found out there's only 3 meetings that we got to have with these psychiatrists or psychologists. And I went to 2 of the meetings, felt good, but I found that the break in between, you could only go, like, you could make an appointment and you feel great coming out of there after, you know, you felt more positive and stuff, you know, you kind of saw the light at the end of the tunnel, but your next appointment couldn't have been till maybe 2.5-3 weeks later, because that person's so booked out.
Yeah.
Maybe because they work with, like, the bulk of construction companies or a lot of different companies around the area. So your next appointment, that 3 weeks, you can suffer a lot in between that time.
So if you,
and
just let's explore that for a moment. So in terms of, you've got to wait, let's say 3 weeks before you can go back to see the psychologist. If you, if you had have trusted the system at work with mates and put your hand up and spoken a bit more openly, do you think that would have helped and made a difference?
I'm not sure, because I was too afraid that it would have got back to management.
Yeah.
And I could have been penalized.
Okay.
Construction these days is a real cutthroat.
Gotcha. Yeah.
Bottom line.
Yeah. And so you,
if you're, mentally not well, you'll get pushed aside, told to go home, and anywhere they can push you under the rug or boot you out, they will.
Okay. So what led to you being incarcerated?
The relationship, and it went down for, to be honest, it was self-harm. I wanted to hurt myself.
Yep.
And the partner at the time contacted the police, and she swung the whole story around, and I ended up inside.
Okay.
Which was, everything she told was complete.
Okay. Yep.
And, but obviously, in New Zealand, the system is everyone's guilty until proven innocent.
When it comes to domestic relationships, I have to agree with you.
Anything.
Yeah.
Well, so, anything. So New Zealand's the only country that does it. In the rest of the world, is you're all innocent until proven guilty.
In
New Zealand, you're all guilty until proven innocent.
In terms of the psychologist that you were seeing,
yeah.
Did you get, but once the police got involved, were you able to make contact and have follow-up?
Not at all. No, I had no support, nothing.
So have you had any follow-up since?
No. No. Because of my restrictions and stuff, it's been placed on me. I can't do anything.
And
I'm like, you guys all complaining about level 4. I'm at like a level 6.5.
Don't tell us where, because we don't want to expose you to anything that may get you in trouble, Jeff. right, guys, taking your calls. 0800 844 747. Magic talks our name.
And well, lucky Powerball tickets is now worth 42.2 million. Wonderful player. I kind of had a little dream, or a little nice little daydream that it would be shared, you know, even two people. A ticket falls in the small Waikato town of Pukeno. This is a town with a population of 3,320 people. It was the bacon stock, but someone took the bacon over what I did. Conversations, our game.
So you hear on, you know, on the media like TV and stuff, you can now claim it.
Having that knowledge to help them, it's just having something in common, because 20 years because of issues from her childhood. So for 7 years, I ran a program with at-risk youth with no funding from the government whatsoever for 7 years. They all said, all the government departments said,